Sega!
Captain's Log Supplemental. After hearing O'Bannock's request, I decided to look into the matter personally. Kai Wynn objected to our helping an infidel visit the temple, but she agreed to let us proceed after we promised her we'd handle the matter with the utmost discretion. On a more personal note, I believe the temple may hold an explanation for these nightmares I've been having lately. I can't help but believe these visions are prophecies of some kind. And that worries me greatly.
Vessel has established orbit. They're beaming troops to your location. The smaller impulse ship has entered the moon's atmosphere and is heading toward the facility.
Dax, notify the station and the Bajoran government that we're under attack and require immediate assistance. Away team, ready your weapons. Look sharp. We still have a job to do.
Thank you.
Looks like I'll need an isotillinium inductor to restore the auxiliary generator.
Sir, those are widely used in Bajoran technology. You should be able to find a compatible part.
Mission objectives.
Lyrobanic, sections of the facility have been locked off.
You'll need access cards to enter those areas.
Understood. Sisko out. Chief, sections of the facility are locked off.
Sir, you'll need access cards to reach those areas.
Acknowledged. Sisko out.
Vessel has established orbit. They're beaming troops to your location. The smaller impulse ship has entered the moon's atmosphere and is heading toward the facility.
Dax, notify the station and the Bajoran government that we're under attack and require immediate assistance. Away team, ready your weapons. Look sharp. We still have a job to do. Sisko to O'Brien. I have the inductor.
Okay, Captain. Use your tricorder to determine which Nadion port is offline, and insert the capacitor. Then, reinitialize the generator using the console.
Understood. Sisko out.
assistance, Captain.
Acknowledged. Sisko out. Chief, sections of the facility are locked off.
Sir, you'll need access cards to reach those areas.
Understood. Sisko out. Sisko to run about. I've reached the temple. It's magnificent.
Concentrated magnesite deposits within the rock are causing severe signal degradation.
Acknowledged. Sisko out. Sisko to Obanik. I'm standing in front of an obelisk. There are four switches, each with unique markings.
You're describing an ancient Bajoran locking mechanism. Pressing the switches in the correct order should open a hidden alcove or a passageway.
You wouldn't know what the correct order is.
I'm afraid not, emissary. Every obelisk is unique. But at other archaeological sites, the sequence was often depicted in nearby inscriptions. Take a good look around you.
Understood. Sisko out.
Retrieved files.
Sisko to Obanik. There are two obelisks outside the main entrance to the shrine. Both obelisks have outer casings, and I believe there are switches hidden behind them.
Fascinating. I'm not familiar with this configuration, Emissary. Examine your surroundings carefully, Emissary. There may be inscriptions to guide you, or other switches.
Acknowledged. Sisko out.
Obanik, there's a door with an inscription of a holy man. He looks like he's meant to be holding something.
You are correct, Emissary. The custodian should be holding a tablet. I have a replica of this locking system in my monastery. If you insert a tablet into the recess, the door will open.
Understood. Sisko out.
Thank you.
Sisko to Obanik. There are two obelisks outside the main entrance to the shrine.
Pressing the switches in the correct order should open a hidden alcove or a passageway.
Acknowledged. Sisko out.
Mr. Worf, set your tricorder to make a holographic scan of the mural.
Aye, sir.
Dax to Captain Sisko.
Good to hear your voice, old man. Report.
O'Brien adjusted the comm system's frequency harmonics to compensate for the planet's magnesite deposits.
Good work. And the call time?
Retreating. Three Bajoran militia cruisers are en route. They'll be here in 4 minutes. What's your status, Ben?
We found the shrine. There aren't any orbs here, but we found a mural that might be of some help.
Complete, Captain.
We're finished here, Dax. Radio ahead and tell Quark we're going to need Holosuite 1.
For how long?
As long as it takes.
And if he objects?
Tell him I insist. 3 to beam up.
Captain's log, stardate 51957.9. We're on our way back to Deep Space Nine, where we'll take a closer look at the mural from the temple. The Bajoran government has assured me it'll conduct a thorough investigation of the Kal Tan attack on the Gerardo Temple. Meanwhile, Odo tells me that the Carnelian Circle, a civilian medical organization on Cardassia, has sent Provost Dejar to take over the investigation regarding the two dead Cardassian soldiers we found in the bulkhead this morning.
But seeing as O'Brien just found a hidden laboratory on the other side of that bulkhead, I've told Odo not to cede jurisdiction just yet.
I've uploaded my preliminary analysis of the Gerardo mural to your pad. It's clear the mural depicts the three orbs of the Paw Wraiths and the wormhole, but it's not clear what that relationship is. I'll set the computer to begin translating the ideograms. However, the translation will take several hours, or maybe even days.
Security has completed a level 4 scan of the Cardassian shuttle. It is not armed. Nonetheless, we should minimize the length of their visit and monitor their activities at all times.
The Carnelian Circle appreciates your cooperation in this matter. We are trying to locate all the Cardassians who went missing in action during the Bajoran occupation. The victims you discovered were actually part of Gul Dukat's elite guard. As you might imagine, there's considerable political pressure to investigate their deaths. There are those who believe Dukat might have killed them to conceal one of his more heinous war crimes. We'll return to Cardassia once we've conducted our own examination of the laboratory.
According to the station schematics, the laboratory in Pylon 2 doesn't exist. The Cardassians disguise the space by making the adjoining sections appear larger than they really are. But that's not the best part. The power conduits to the lab have been rerouted, so that even the computer doesn't know it exists. Bloody Cardies.
Captain, Obanik's gone back to Bajor to help his brethren restore the monastery, and to study the hollow scan of the mural.
It surprises me that the Cardassians would send Carnelian Circle specialists to retrieve the bodies of two low-ranking soldiers, unless they weren't mere soldiers. On the other hand, if the Cardassians really are here to conduct an investigation, this might be even more serious than we think.
Sir?
When I heard we were expecting Cardassian visitors, it was music to my ears. At last, I thought, I'll finally be able to shift those crates of Kanar left behind from the Cardassian occupation. Imagine my disappointment when I discovered there were only three Cardassians aboard that big shuttle. And none of them bring Kanar! It's like my father always said, when you're looking to make a profit, you can't beat a drunk Cardassian.
I've completed my analysis of the soldiers' remains. They weren't beamed into the hull. Judging from the molecular disruption in their tissue and the surrounding metal, it appears the Cardassians and the bulkhead were struck by a concentrated spatial distortion field. The question is, what caused the distortion field?
sir.
I presume the Carnelian Circle have come to retrieve their fallen comrades and investigate their mysterious deaths. I must say, that's quite a lofty honor for two lowly soldiers.